Not as the world gives to you, do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Jesus knew. He knew that parting times are not an occasion for easy assurances. Parting times are not occasions for false promises, no. It's the time to turn to the continuing presence of the one who never says goodbye. The promise that even in our saying goodbye to each other, we are gathered up together in the peace of God. And then there's the Apostle Paul. If anybody said goodbye a lot, it was Paul. You know, think of all his travels, church to church. He had lots of experience saying goodbye. And in the letters of Paul that we still have these days, his parting words are always offered with a sense of deep urgency, deep love. He takes his time. He gives his heart room to share the depth of his feelings. I hope you heard that in the scripture lesson. When Paul closed his final letter to the Corinthian Christians, he really lays his heart out there on the line. Now, my friends, goodbye. Strive for perfection. Listen to my appeals. Agree with one another. Live in peace. God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with the kiss of peace. All of God's people send their greetings to you. Grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. A blessing from the heart. That's what you find in the Bible. People who in parting from one another, remind one another of the promises of God. Which makes total sense if you think about it. I mean, what other way are we supposed to say goodbye? How else are we supposed to do it? How else can you say goodbye to people you love unless you entrust them to the care of God? When the time comes to part, we have to turn each other over to God because we can no longer be there for each other. How else can we look at all the things that we have not had the ability or the time to say or do? And all the broken fragments of our congregational life over the years, how else can we face this time of saying goodbye unless we ask God to gather all up and somehow make it whole? To complete whatever we were not able to complete. To heal whatever we were not able to heal. I don't know another way to do it. I don't know how to leave you except to say, God be with you. God be with you. Did you know that's what the word goodbye means? God be with you. Goodbye is a contraction of the words God be with ye. Four words scrunched down into one word. That's what we're saying when we say goodbye. We're saying God be with you. God be with you. Though very soon, I will no longer be with you. God be with you, because in the days ahead, we will have only limited ways of expressing care for one another. God be with you, because if God is with you and God is with me, then we can both move on, knowing that everything is in God's hands. God be with you. Because even though our lives are not much more than a collection of fragments, God promises to make make us complete and make us whole in God's good time. I've always thought of myself as a highly trained professional. And I've reminded of you that many times over the years. But I've never retired before. And it's hard to leave the ministry full time. It's hard to leave you, CPC. It is. In fact, there may be no way at all for me to leave you whom I love so much. No way to do it without simply telling you goodbye from the bottom of my heart. Because I know you'll be in good hands. You are in God's hands. So, goodbye. God be with you. Goodbye. God be with you. Amen. come now to our Lord's table to celebrate the sacrament of our Lord's Supper. When Jesus was at the table with his disciples, he took bread and broke it and gave it to them and said, "This is my broken body given for you. Eat of it, all of you. Together we eat the bread." Same way, after they had eaten, our Savior took the cup and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my shed blood given for you. Drink of it, all of you. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the saving death of our risen Lord until he comes." Together we drink the cup. Let us pray. It is a noisy season, O God. We are surrounded by a blast of sounds which seem to make silence impossible. There are the sounds of worried people who are spending more than they can afford. There are the sounds of impatient people who wish the slow people would get out of their way. There are the sounds of angry people who missed a sale item. And there are the gaudy commercial sounds intended to put us in the spirit of the season. We hear it all, and we are a part of it all. Oh God, don't give up on us. We do want to get to the true meaning of this season. And if silence will help, then put your hand on our busyness and stay with us until we are willing to listen and ponder something other than that which is earthly. Lord, in your kindness, hear our prayer. Keep us, O God, however, from a kind of holy escape. Surely your coming was something deeply earthly minded, and your investment in the world was to come as one of us and one with us. We don't want to miss the significance of that truth. Whatever we do in this season must witness to the connection between you and the world. Show us how to celebrate that good news. Lord, in your kindness, hear our prayer. Yes, it is a noisy season, God, so if we must be less than silent, let us at least be noisy in our praise and our thanks for your coming among us. Let our voices join those who sing glad melodies. Let our noise be the noise of peace and goodwill among all people. Let our celebration be a search for simplicity in the midst of life's complexity, for love amidst violence and hate. Give us time for joy despite the reality of pain and hurt, a time for hope that abides in the face of whatever forms of despair may plague us. Lord, in your kindness, hear our prayer. We remember those among us who have special needs this day, O God. We pray for those who are sick. We pray for those who must live with uncertain futures. We pray for those who wish their lives could be less complicated and more simple. We pray for those who are afraid to move on with life because they don't know which direction to go. We pray for those who bear great disappointment. Be with them to strengthen and support them. Lord, we pray for our world. We're so quick at times, so slow at peace. Encourage all efforts at helping to further goodwill on earth. Lord, in your kindness, hear our prayer. We lift our prayers this day for those we know who have particular needs, praying for Jason Hammond, for Ann Winters. Pray for Jean Wunderly and her family and their grief. For Herb Miller. We pray for Bonnie Sumner and her family and their grief. We pray for Patty Walker Jordan, for Fran Hart, and we pray for Dick Horn. Lord, in your kindness, hear our prayer. You do hear our prayer, O God. You hear all our prayers. So hear us now as we pray in the words that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Now let us worship God through the giving of our gifts. keep the faith, live in hope, love one another. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance on you and give you peace through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Down here.